गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द डे 7 विद आवर चैप्टर वाटर रिसोर्सेज. इन अर्लियर वीडियोस वी हैव ऑलरेडी टॉक्ड अबाउट
सोर्सेज ऑफ वाटर. डू वी मीन बाय द वर्ड इरिगेशन एंड व्हिच आर द डिफरेंट मींस ऑफ इरिगेशन
एंड अबाउट नीड ऑफ वाटर कंजर्वेशन.
इन टुडेज वीडियो वी विल बी लर्निंग अबाउट रेन वाटर हार्वेस्टिंग, अबाउट द एडवांटेजेस एंड द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ रेन वाटर हार्वेस्टिंग, about different techniques of rainwater harvesting and about the recharge of groundwater.
While going through this topic, we will be learning some new words
like water harvesting. Water harvesting means capturing rainwater where it fall and capture runoff from the catchment and stream, etc. Rainwater harvesting, the activity of collecting rainwater directly or recharging it into the ground to improve groundwater storage in the aquifer. Rooftop rainwater harvesting, collecting rainwater over the rooftops and channelizing through PVC pipes into the ground pits, wells or borewells. Groundwater, the water present beneath the earth's surface in the soil pores and in the fracture of rocks.
So now students, let's start with our topic rainwater harvesting, which is given in page number 163 of your book. Before going ahead with the topic, let's know something about this topic.
Rainwater harvesting. Harvesting is the process of collecting a natural resource to use it effectively.
Rainwater harvesting is a type of harvest in which the raindrops are collected and stored for the future use rather than allowing them to run off. Rainwater can be collected from a river or a roof and redirected to a deep pit, well, borehole, an aquifer, etc. It uses water for garden, livestock, irrigation, domestic use with a proper treatment. The harvested water can also be used as drinking water and in longer term storage, it can be used as groundwater recharge. Rainwater harvest is one of the simplest and the oldest methods of self-supply of water for the household, usually financed by the users. With depleting groundwater levels and fluctuating climate conditions, capturing rainwater can help recharge local aquifer, reduce urban flooding, and most importantly, ensure water availability. Now let's start with the reading of the topic, rainwater harvesting. Harvesting is the process of collecting natural resources to use it effectively. So rainwater harvesting means collecting rainwater for using it effectively. Water harvesting involves all the different methods of conserving and collecting rainwater. Here the word comes water harvesting. Water harvesting means capturing rainwater where it falls and capture runoff from the catchment and streams, etc. Generally, water harvesting is direct rainwater collection. This collected water could be stored for the later use and recharged into the groundwater again. It is the simplest and the most efficient method of water conservation. There are various methods of water harvesting. Number one, rainwater harvesting. Rainwater harvesting in a layman language is the collection of rainwater and recharging of the groundwater. Groundwater recharge is a hydrological process where water moves downward from the surface water to groundwater. Recharge is the primary method through which water enters an aquifer. Aquifer means a watery basin.
Water harvesting. Definition. The activity of collecting rainwater directly or recharging. Recharging is a process through which water enters an aquifer. Aquifer means a watery basin. Into the ground to improve groundwater storage in an aquifer.
The most important technique for storing water and later using it during the drought or dry season. This we have already learned in our junior classes, that rainwater harvesting means the storing of rainwater that is used later during the time of drought. Drought means the long spell of dry weather. It can be used for irrigation, for domestic purposes, for running the industries, for agriculture, etc. In this method, the rainwater is collected on the rooftop and is directed to dry tanks. Here, the rainwater is collected on the rooftop and is taken to the dry tanks with the help of the PVC pipes. The complete setup is channelized with the help of the PVC pipes. The pipes can also be connected to the wells, bore wells, or directly to an aquifer beneath the ground, which also helps in recharging the groundwater level. Now next is objectives of rainwater harvesting. Now here the question arises that why should we conserve this rainwater? Why should we store this rainwater? So number one is recharging the groundwater and raising its level. In a layman language, if I speak, it means to increase the level of water beneath the earth's surface. Because the rainwater that is stored is sent to the ground with the help of the PVC pipes, which helps in raising the water level in the aquifer. Checking the rainwater from flowing far away so as to prevent soil erosion. Soil erosion means removal of the top layer of soil by wind and water, or flooding. Flooding means overflow of the water on the normally dry tank. It can be due to the dam break or heavy rainfall of the surrounding areas. When rain falls on the landscape, it does not just sit there and wait to be evaporated by the sun or lapped up by the local wildlife. It begins to move. Some of it seeps into the ground to refresh groundwater, but most of it flows down gradient as a surface runoff. Hence, storing water by harvesting, we can stop this and can use water later. Checking rainwater from becoming polluted. Rainwater harvested from the rooftops is nearly as clean as pure water. A number of contaminants can be present in such water. It is possible to control water quality and bring it to the acceptable level by simple and inexpensive devices, meeting the demands of water requirement in the dry season. The water stored can be used in a dry season for irrigation, for domestic purposes, etc. Now next is rooftop rainwater harvesting method. In this image, you can see that the rainwater is collected over the rooftops and is channelized through small PVC pipes into sand filter, collection tank, and recharge well. This is the most important method to conserve rainwater and to replenish the groundwater. Start rooftop rainwater harvesting method. Rooftop rainwater harvesting and conservation system comprises a simple scheme to replenish. Replenish means to fill up again the groundwater and increase its level. But obvious, if the water will again fill up in the aquifers, the level of the water will rise. Rainwater can be collected over the rooftops within our house premises and can be channelized through the small PVC pipes into the ground pits. Pit means a hollow or indentation in a surface. Sump is a pit or a hollow in which the liquid is collected. Borewell is a deep well for water that is drilled into the ground and has a pipe to be used by the hand pump or from the wells. This from this particular image. Purpose is to utilize the rainwater to its maximum and not to let it run off or go waste. If we are not storing this rainwater, it will lead to flood or creating wetlands. But if we are storing this rainwater, it can be utilized later for many purposes. Nearly 50,000 liters of rainwater can be harvested from 100 square meter of rooftop area. And this canned water can be reused also. Since the rooftop rainwater does not require major expenditure, it is not so expensive. It only needs an aquifer and a PVC pipe to store, to channelize the complete setup. It should be made compulsory by the government before the houses plan is approved by the municipal corporation. Municipal corporation is a local self-government in the urban areas. Harvesting techniques is being used in Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, along with Assam, Rajasthan and Maharashtra. Many states have made it a government policy, specifically the states which are
facing droughts in the dry season. As this technique is very simple, practical and cost effective, it is not so expensive. It can be done by us also. It can be easily practiced by individuals, both in towns as well as villages. What is the importance of rainwater harvesting? Now, what are the advantages of the rainwater harvesting? As we have already read, that rainwater harvesting helps in increasing the groundwater level. It is helping us in the drought and dry season. It is cost effective and it can be easily set up. So it needs less initial cost to set up this rainwater harvesting system. So let's read. Rainwater harvesting increases the availability of water during dry season by increasing the level of dried borewells and wells. The rooftops are connected with these dried wells, tube wells and hand pumps. Through the help of the PVC pipes, the water is channelized into these wells and tube wells, which help in increasing the level of water in these wells, tube wells, etc. Surface water supply is readily available for various purposes, thus reducing dependence on underground water. The water stored can be used later, so we need not to disturb our groundwater. It improves the quality of groundwater by diluting salinity. As we all know that the rainwater is a pure form of water, so it helps in diluting the salt present in the water. It decreases the level of salt in the water. It does not cause pollution and is environment friendly because it does not need any sort of electricity to process or any type of diesel. So it does not cause pollution. It is cost effective and easily affordable, that I have already told. It reduces soil erosion because if the water is stored, there will be no flooding, hence there will be no soil erosion. The surface water will lead to runoff the soil, but here the water is stored, so there is no soil erosion. Soil erosion means removal of the top layer of soil by wind and water. It improves soil moisture. It helps the soil to retain the moisture. The rainwater can be stored and used till next rainfall. This can even provide for drinking water when all the other sources have dried up. We know that the water can dry up in the canals, wells, but this stored water can be used later at that particular time also. Our next topic is rainwater techniques in different states of India. In India, rainwater harvesting is an ancient tradition. It is known by different names in the different states of India. Harvesting techniques in different states. Rainwater harvesting techniques. In India, rainwater harvesting is an ancient tradition. As early as 4500 BC, people of Thar Desert and Rajasthan have been harvesting rainwater. Harvesting means storing rainwater, especially in the forms of tankas. Tankas are the underground tanks found in Rajasthan. Many other states in India still use the traditional methods of rainwater harvesting. These are known by the different names in the different states of India, but the main motive is to conserve rainwater. Johar, earthen tanks. Johar is a rainwater storage tank principally used in the states of Haryana and Rajasthan that collects and stores water throughout the year to be used for the purpose of drinking by human cattle. They are also known as khadan in Jaisalmer. Kunds, covered underground tanks in Rajasthan. Tanks, underground small tanks, and khadan, a long earthen embankment to store runoff water in Gujarat. Chiruva in Andhra Pradesh. Chiruva are found in Chittoor district in Andhra Pradesh. They are the reservoir to store runoff. Dongs, ponds in Assam by Bodo tribe, Kere, tanks in Karnataka. There are other names also which are used, like Bhandras are the check dams or diversions that are built across the river in Maharashtra. Bengal rainwater is stored in ponds called Pukwa, Bill and Khal. Jammu Kashmir rainwater is stored in Zongs. So these all are the traditional names that you all have to learn.
Rainwater harvesting managers are called Pallar, are an officially recognized caste in India that deserve to be honored. They are also known as Mallar. They have learned the techniques of rainwater harvesting from their ancestors and have been continued to them, use them down the generations. So they all are using this all method now also. Today rainwater harvesting is practiced in most of the large cities like Chennai, Bengaluru, Delhi and Mumbai. Most of the states like Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Tamil Nadu, Assam and Rajasthan have made it a government policy. But this should imply to the complete India, not only India, throughout the world, because this only can save water for the future use. Our next topic is groundwater recharge. Groundwater. Recharge of groundwater is a process through water enters an aquifer. It is a new concept of rainwater harvesting and the structures. Structures means the places where the rainwater is stored and helps in draining the water to the aquifer. Generally is used for this purpose are pit recharge. Pits are constructed to recharge the shallow aquifers. Shallow means not so deep. This is trenches. Trenches is a type of depression in the ground that is generally deeper and narrow. These are constructed when the water is collected at a shallow depth due to the permeable soil. Permeable soil means the water that can seep water into it. Next is dug wells. Wells are the deep hose dug to take out underground water. Water is carried with the help of filtration tank from where it flows into the dug wells. Is hand pumps. Nowadays the hand pumps are not in use. So these hand pumps are used to fill up the aquifers. The rooftops are connected with the bore wells of the hand pumps and it helps in recharging the groundwater level. The existing hand pumps may be used for recharging the shallow or deep aquifers if the water availability is scarce. So with this, our chapter is finished. Students, please try to revise the previous topics also and try to solve the related exercises. Thank you.